Guitar shifts. The time has come. We are now 100,000 strong. Didn't really seem that climactic. Let's try that again with some editing.
We are now 100,000 strong.
100,000 achievement unlocked. Also, as promised, in this video, I'll be doing my second microwave reveal as well as new apartment tour. I hope you're excited for this. You're probably in quarantine or something anyway, so you're welcome for bringing some excitement into your stupid life. But we'll get to all that later. Also, toward the end of this video, I'll be sending out a message to another musician here on YouTube. He does not know this message is coming. Don't want to miss that. All right, guitar chefs. It's time for some recap. At the start of 2020, my channel had a pathetic little audience of 1,200 people. But I set out a goal this year to grow. Up until that point, I was really only posting on Instagram. And if you look at my earlier videos on YouTube, you'll notice that a lot of them tend to be a minute long or less. But the problem was I was getting bored with Instagram because I had already done basically every idea you can think of, and I just wanted a new challenge. So one day I came across the Davey 504 video, and in that video, he told people to make reaction videos to his content.
Oh no, I can't find any other reaction videos, very sad. So, I challenge you to make a reaction video of one of my videos. Do it now.
I used this opportunity to create the legendary How to Davey 504. After creating that video, I took a minute-long clip from it and posted it to Instagram. The plan here was to get my followers to spam Davey 504 with the video and send it to him in his DMs and everything until he saw it. If everything worked out correctly, he would see the video, actually like it, and then feature it in one of his videos on his channel. Long story short, it worked, and my channel went from 1,200 subscribers to 15,000 in 24 hours. In that How to Davey 504 video, I said that once I reached 10,000 subscribers, I would be doing a microwave reveal. Once my channel reaches 10,000 subs, I will reveal to you the location of my microwave. Subscribe now! So I did that, and then I announced that I would be doing a second microwave reveal along with a new apartment tour when I reached 100,000 subscribers, because I moved. That day has arrived. But before we get to that, I just want to once again send my thanks to Davey 504. You, sir, are a boss. And everybody should go subscribe to his channel. I also see haters in my comment section saying that I'm trying to literally copy him. If you've been watching my channel, you've probably even seen some yourself. But I just want to make something clear. If I truly wanted to copy Davey 504, there would not be any trying. I would successfully do it. I've watched so much of his content that I could easily mimic him, and I already know all the technical stuff that has to do with editing. So to like the thousand of you that keep saying that I'm ripping off Davey 504, I want you to know that I'm actually trying to be less like him. But I'm new to YouTube, so give me some goddamn time. And a lot of what Davey does is my kind of humor. I find that shit funny as hell. But I've stopped watching him because I want to sound less like him. It's fucking sad, mate. I never take YouTube comments too seriously though, because a lot of you motherfuckers say the dumbest shit I've ever heard in my life. Somebody once said that I was copying Rudy Ayoub because I was staring into the camera too much. Really? Are you kidding me? Look, I love Rudy, but he didn't invent staring, you actual dumb piece of shit. Like, how stupid are you? People often don't have context in the comment section either. I once saw someone say, "Hey, you got a new guitar," when I was playing my old guitar in a video. That wasn't a negative comment, but it still kind of gives you an idea of how little context people actually have and how a lot of people just kind of assume things. I once posted a video on Instagram where I was playing the blues with one of my students. And there was some idiot in the comment section who said, "Wow, you post a video with your student and don't even let him play?" Which, yes, I was the one soloing, but I had asked him before we started filming if he wanted to play a solo, and he said no. So this douchebag in the comments was just assuming that I wouldn't let him play, and I made the video all about me. The comment section can be very toxic, and if you hate my content, I only have one thing to say to you. I'm definitely gonna get demonetized for this. I originally wanted to pursue social media in 2017 after I graduated from St. Francis Xavier University with my music degree. I taught myself how to use a camera and how to edit, but I was getting zero traffic on my channel. I'm talking like a week would go by and I might get one subscriber. So yeah, it might seem like I grew kind of fast since the shout out from Davey, but in reality, I had been trying to figure this out for 2.5 years beforehand. I did successfully figure out Instagram growth, which is what led to my growth on YouTube. All I'm trying to say is that it wasn't easy and it still isn't. But I decided to not be a pussy and go for it. And to hold myself accountable, I posted a video in 2017 saying that in 5 years' time, I would have 1 million subscribers on YouTube. That would mean having 1 million subscribers specifically by September 2022. Guitar Chefs, let's make it happen. I will have 1 million subscribers on YouTube by September of 2022. Let's test me. No failing allowed. My dignity is officially on the line. Should I fail? Everyone will know. And I give you permission to call me a pussy. Not gonna lie, bit nervous to make that statement, but I'm a really big believer in stepping out of your comfort zone. You gotta have balls, mate. And at the current rate I'm growing, I won't actually hit 1 million subscribers by then. So fucking subscribe. Otherwise, I'm gonna look like a dumbass in front of hundreds of thousands of people, which would be kind of funny, but at the end of the day, I want to inspire people. And if I don't have the balls to put myself out there, then how will I truly inspire them? And besides, it's gonna be a better story when I do reach 1 million and I show a clip of this video. Anyway, enough recap bullshit. Time to take you guys on a tour of my apartment. This is a closet where I store boxes. I'm technically not allowed to use that AC, but they're on cigarettes if they think I'm not gonna use that in the summer. I've got a clock and a blanket and some shoes and shit. I just wanna point out that I had this toilet paper way before the pandemic started. Got a nice beer pong table here that never gets used because I don't have any friends. Has some even nicer designs on it. Here's the bathroom. Got a shower, but I never use that shit. What am I, a woman or something? Got some mouthwash here. And I'm not even being paid to talk about this. Now Crest is gonna get 1 million sales all because of me. Where's my sponsor, assholes? Fucking Dennis douchebags. Got some shoes, another mirror, got a closet. My gym bag, which I can't even go to the gym because of the coronavirus. And here we have my room. I've got a nice painting there that I've never put up. Some guitars, I have a chair. Somebody once asked me if I was a minimalist. I can certainly understand why somebody might think that, but the answer is no. Real talk though, I don't think happiness comes from material possessions. I think it comes from achieving goals, kind of like today. Let's get drunk to celebrate. Just kidding, I have no friends. Here we have the living room. I have a standing desk because I don't need to sit down like a bitch. If I want to be a bitch though, I can because I have a crank right here and I can use this to adjust the height. I have another chair, but I don't have a couch. My family was making fun of me for it. I had never been so disrespected in my entire life. All right, now it's time for the microwave reveal. Yeah, so that was a lot less climactic than the first one, but it's fucking mounted to the wall, mate. What do you expect? As for the rest of my kitchen, I've got a fridge that no matter how hard I try to clean these streaks off of it, they don't go away. But my cupboards are chill as fuck because no matter how hard I slam them, they just close slowly. Got some lights and shit. Got some more lights and shit. Got my oven that I use to cook shit. Why don't we cook something right now? So now that I've revealed to you my second microwave in my new apartment, we need a new milestone to work toward. 250K, what should I reveal? Leave your suggestions in the comments. And if this video has brought you any joy so far, make sure you fuck up that like button. And you see that dislike button? Neither do I. Moving forward. Guitar Chefs, we all want to be rich. And anybody that says otherwise is lying. So I created a Patreon page so you can give me your money for no reason. I thought to myself, how can I make more money without actually putting in any extra effort whatsoever? And Patreon was the solution. And with Patreon, there are different levels of tiers that you can sign up to, depending on how much money you want to give me. In return, I'll give you nothing. If you sign up to the first tier, you'll get nothing. If you sign up to the second tier, you'll get everything included from the previous tier, plus nothing. If you sign up to the highest tier, you'll get everything from the previous tiers plus a whole load of nothing.
I know, it seems too good to be true.
What an honor it would be for you to give me your money that you worked hard for, especially considering the world is about to go into a recession.
You see, I used to have a Patreon page.
It pissed me off!
But I wasn't even mad. But now I only focus on YouTube and my guitar program, 52 Week Guitar Player. I don't want any more bullshit to worry about. And you, an intellectual, understand that. So give me your money for no reason. God, I'm such a great person.
Do you remember earlier in the video when I said I had a message for another musician on YouTube?
Rob Scallon, I have a message to send you.
I need your help. When Davey504 gave me a shout out, I said that I would repay him someday. That day approaches, but I can't carry out this mission alone. I know you and him are good fucking friends. So as his friend, I wanted to reach out to you so that we can plan this together. I already know what I want to do, and it's a big task, which is why I want to start now. Maybe in a few months we can pull it off. So check your DMs and let's arrange a Skype call and get down to business.
Should you ignore this message?
I'm going to assume that you secretly hate Crest Mouthwash and you're angry at me for supporting them. If that's the case, I understand. But perhaps we can look past that and help out our favorite bass player, Young Davey. And that's gonna be it for this video, chefs. Oh, and one last thing. Guitar chefs, thanks. But don't subscribe to my channel. In fact, you know what? Just leave, okay? I don't want you here.